this week on Pickwick Lake out of Muscle Shoals, Alabama, with my good friend and Strike King buddy, Roger Stegall.
What we're going to do today is we're going to fish for some crappie. And the way I fish for crappie is a lot like I'm bass fishing. We're going to be casting little 1/8 and 1/16 ounce jigs, just tight lining.
Wow, look at them colors on that thing. That didn't take
what
long.
About that? That was about your third cast, wasn't it?
Does Roger know where to go? That's
there's
right.
One right there.
Right
look
there.
At there. Look at there.
And he's pulling good, isn't he?
Old crappie. Carl's had real good luck on. I've had a lot of good luck at the Strike King. Slabalicious. It's like, I call it a wedge tail. It's actually a new design. Usually you used to use a curly tail, and now they've got that wedge tail, and it actually puts out some vibration and wiggles a lot too. I mean, it's got a lot of action to it.
Megan, always a good one too.
Put them in the boat.
Oh yeah. Pickwick crappie. Swinging them like largemouth, huh?
I guarantee you.
Now is Pickwick on? Right away, but a little bit of drizzle and rain, who cares? I got rain gear, Roger's got rain gear. We're gonna try to catch some crappie and have some fun and then eat them later.
When it goes slack, you know you're on the bottom. Then you start reeling it real slow like this. And you stop it, let it fall back.
Wait. Oh, that's a nice crappie. Attaboy, Roger. Oh, nice one, eh?
Oh yeah.
Yes, sir. Wow.
Where it needs to be.
Attaboy, attaboy. Oh,
I saw that.
Goodness, do you look at that.
Sound good.
Look
he
at
thumped
that.
It.
Did he thump that or what, folks? Look at that. Hold my skirt down.
That's a black crappie there now.
Oh, yeah, right.
That speckle
right.
He is.
Yeah.
Yep.
No bars, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Nice. Look where he's got it, too.
Yep.
Just in the nose, boy.
Look at that. What is that? Good one. Saw him on the screen. I just kept fluttering it along there and caught him. Good deal. Strike King jigs to catch them, I'm telling you.
And we just wanted to bring champies to the bring a little delta to the shoals.
You can't come to this area and fish without eating some of your product there that you've done. So this is what we call our little Delta Delight. It is a our version of a catfish plate. This is what we finished up, a little fried gold here. This is our Delta Delight, our catfish plate, 4 jumbo tenders, 2 homemade hush puppies, our beer battered french fries and cool coleslaw. You gotta finish it off with a little tartar sauce. You can't beat it, and a little slice of red onion. It's awesome.
I'm Carl Kalonka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way. Visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine. On Pickwick Lake, out of Muscle Shoals, Alabama, with my good friend and Strike King buddy, Roger Stegall. Roger guides full-time for bass, stripers, crappie, you name it. But this time of year, when the crappie are plentiful, they're biting, they're everywhere, he knows where to find them, he knows how to catch them. So we came down here to have some fun in good old Sweet Home, Alabama, catch some crappie, meet some good people, have some good times, just like we always do in the Deep South. So sit back, enjoy, and we'll show you how Pickwick Lake is a place you should consider when you want to go crappie fishing in the spring, summer, fall, winter, it doesn't matter. Whenever you want to go, Muscle Shoals, Alabama is waiting for you.
What we're going to do today is we're going to fish for some crappie. And the way I fish for crappie is a lot like I'm bass fishing. We're going to be casting little 1/8 and 1/16 ounce jigs, just tight lining. And I use it exclusively all Strike King baits. I use a Slabalicious jig heads, and I use some curly tails, some wedge tails, different ones that Strike King's got. We got a big variety of crappie baits now, and I think we'll catch some fish today. We got water rising, as you can see out in the lake, it's trash everywhere, but I think we should have a good day. We've been catching a lot of crappie, and it'll be a good time to fish today.
How about color wise and stuff, Roger? Did it make a big difference?
We got clouds right now, and the chartreuse does better right now. Chartreuse and red, solid chartreuse, chartreuse glitter, some of the tuxedo colors, chartreuse and black, pink and black. Those colors are real good.
Right on. Okay, let's have some fun.
Try that one, and I'm gonna try the
okay.
same color to start with. All right, you'll cast him out there. Let it go all the way to the bottom. When it goes slack, you know you're on the bottom. And then you start reeling it real slow like this. And you stop it, let it fall back. When the line goes slack again, you know it's on the bottom. And you reel it again until you go slack.
And usually they're there, thump, or they're just there, right?
When it's falling, it'll go thump, or your line will just tighten up, or you'll see your line go to moving off to the side. There's two or three different ways that they'll bite it. But the ideal situation is when you stop it, he goes thump, you see your line jump. I mean, it'll jump when he gets it.
Here we are, right there.
There you go, right there.
Right there, Roger. Boy, he thumped that
good
too.
Deal.
Oh, nice crappie too. Look at that.
Put them in the boat.
Wow, look at them colors on that thing. That didn't take
what
long.
About that? That's about your third cast, wasn't it?
Does Roger know where to go? Look at the tuxedo colors on that thing.
Oh, man.
He's, warrior he's spawning
pretty,
colors, right?
That's a pretty color. Yeah, they're spawning right now.
Look how he's got it, too.
Yep.
You're right. It wasn't really even in a thump either. It was all of a sudden he's just there.
And it's there.
Boom.
That's right.
You know? Nice crappie.
They'll thump it sometimes.
That's a nice way to start, huh?
Shower rain.
Now, is Pickwick on? Right away, but a little bit of drizzle and rain, who cares? I got rain gear. Roger's got rain gear. We're gonna try to catch some crappie and have some fun and then eat them later. Come on, crappie. Come on, crappie. Just sitting all over this flat, eh?
We might catch one out of here while we're being movie stars.
How many years now have you been guiding now?
Starting my 28th year.
Wow.
We could go out right there, see that dot right there, and we might catch one. I got something that feels soft, baby. Feels like line. You pop it like that right there, if you don't get it, feels like it might be on some line. But, take it like this, pop it like that, and it come right loose. Magical hands. That's what a boy told me one day. Had magical hands.
Thanks, Roger.
Come on now, crappie.
Nice when you feel that little thump or the weight.
Yep. Got him.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good crappie.
Yep.
I think that's the bass fisherman.
Look where you got it. Crappie. Identical to the other one, huh?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I must have landed close to this one's head, Roger, because as soon as it went down.
You got it.
Ooh, look, that's a little bit of weight on them.
Yeah, that's a good crappie.
Pan-sized.
That's a black crappie there now.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah, speckle
right.
He is.
Yeah, yep. No bars, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Nice. Look where he's got it, too.
Yeah.
Just in the nose, boy. He's got a damaged eye, isn't he?
Yeah, it looks like he's one-eyed.
Yeah, it's like a cat.
Yep.
But he can still find the bait.
Yep, that's a good fish.
Poor him. Now he goes in the live well. Look at his one eye here. I'm going to show you this. Look at his eye. It's a one-eyed crappie. He's like a pirate.
Yeah.
There's a good one. And there he goes, into the box, join his friend. All it is, there's so many different ways we're catching them.
I'm a good guide.
Oh, yeah. See, that's what a good guide does. He puts the guys on the fish so the customers and clients catch them. He's caught so many crappie and bass in his life, he doesn't even care. But when the customer, like me, that's what I am today. Like a co-pilot customer, I'm catching them. I feel great. Like a crappie superstar. Let's keep going.
In here, we'll get it right quick.
Nice. Oh, I missed one right there. Do you believe that? I felt it all the way to my hand and I had all that slack in the line. What the heck?
Good one.
A netter?
Might be.
Uh-oh.
If it's a crappie. It's a big old crappie, too.
Is it?
Yeah, boy. Barely hooked.
Oh, boy. Oh, is that a nice one, Roger? Yes, yeah. Sir.
What about that?
Yeah, man.
Jig where it's at. It fell out of his mouth.
And you just changed the colors, too, didn't you?
Yep. Turn that in live well right quick and I'll get it out of there.
Okay. Look at that, man. Fishing
like
Pickwick.
All right.
Good stuff, Roger. Look at the shoulders on him. all nice and thick. Big mouth. What do you say, crappie? You should have kept that yap closed, but now you got it caught and feed us.
I don't know about them Canadians kissing on that.
We've had rain, drizzle, wind, it doesn't matter what it is. We come out here to Alabama and have some fun with Roger, catching some crappie. And again, we do spider rigging, trolling, pulling cranks, bobbers, corks, whatever it is. But today, casting, just like a little crankbait, slow roll off the bottom. They're all over the water column. Roger talked about the lake coming up 3 feet in the last 3 days because of all the rain and stuff, but we're still catching them. We're having fun, and you can too, right here, Muscle Shoals, Alabama, Pickwick Lake, with my buddy Roger Stegall. Fishing right below the boat.
I've seen them sit there. Like I said, it looks like lasagna laying on the bottom.
Right.
They won't be separated from bottom. A lot of people think it's a stump.
Mm-hmm.
You drop that sucker down there, you'll see if it's a stump or not.
That's right.
And just go thump.
Because it did look like stumps.
Yeah. There's a fish right there. Get ready. There's a jig. Got him. Bigger.
Oh, boy. You can swing this one?
I'll net it for you.
Okay. Wow, Roger, that is something else, huh?
Look at that.
You tell me that's not fun, man. Seeing them on the sonar and popping them. And look where they're getting it, too.
Yep. Right.
Look
top
at that.
Of my
head. You never miss those ones, do you? Boy.
Good fish.
That's a bad spot getting them in. That, yeah. The hole gets too big, huh?
Yeah, that's right. Or over in here in this lip right over in here.
Yes.
Over in that tender side. Yeah. You get them in the top of the head.
Yeah.
He's caught.
Awesome, boy. Awesome, man. This is now turning into fun. I mean, it was fun before, but when you see them like that,
yeah.
when you figuring it out, right? Because they're not chasing it that much anymore.
That's
and
so right.
You just say they're below the boat, and sometimes, what did you say again? They look like a stump.
That's right.
But it's not a stump.
It looks like lasagna. That's what it looks like. Laying on the bottom, that reddish looking color.
And it's these things.
That's right. I've caught too many of them doing that.
Nice stuff. Let's put them in here.
I grew up in the Memphis area and spent a lot of time in the Delta, and we just wanted to bring champies to the bring a little Delta to the shoals. I tell you what sets us apart from a lot of places is just the kind of the way we do things. You know, all our chicken comes in fresh, nothing's ever frozen. We marinate it for at least 24 hours in our own secret marinade. Then it's hand breaded and into the fryer, and then right out of the fryer on the plate to your table. So nothing sitting around waiting on you, no heat lamps. I mean, we just try to make it as fresh as possible. It takes a little bit longer, but I mean, it's worth the wait.
But
I guarantee you that.
Worth it, right?
I guarantee you that.
We're going to start out first with kind of what we're known for, and that's some fried chicken. We're going to do a two-piece white setup. So we're going to start out, get a nice big breast here and a big wing. Look at the size of that wing. It might as well be a turkey wing. Into our own breading recipe. Lots of herbs and spices here. And we're gonna give it a good toss 7 to 8 times. All right, right over into the fryer. This is our two-piece white meat plate, a breast and a wing, served with our homemade baked beans and our homemade slaw. The great thing about it is most places use a pound and a half sized bird. We use a 3 to 3.5 pound sized bird. So you can tell in the portions that you're getting, if you leave here hungry, it's your own fault. You can't come to this area and fish without eating some of your product there that you've done. So this is what we call our little Delta Delight. It is our version of a catfish plate. And it is USDA pond raised catfish. This is right here in Alabama, and it's in our own breading, as you can see. We'll give it a couple of good tosses, and then right into the fryer. All right, our Delta Delight is ready. This is what we finished up, a little fried gold here. This is our Delta Delight, our catfish plate, 4 jumbo tenders, 2 homemade hush puppies, our beer battered french fries, and cool coleslaw. You gotta finish it off with a little tartar sauce. You can't beat it, and a little slice of red onion. It's awesome.
This morning we're starting off casting, and we're throwing a 7-foot ultralight with a little 1,000 spinning reel with 6-pound line, and you throw a little 1/8-ounce jig head. What Carl's had real good luck on, I've had a lot of good luck, is a Strike King Slabalicious. It's like, I call it a wedge tail, and you try to keep it on there straight. You just put it on, just like this right here, just thread him on there and keep that wedge tail in line with your hook. Just bring it on there just like that right there and push it up on there. And that little tail just kicks like the dickens when you're swimming it. And we started off throwing this morning, casting, tight line is what we call it. And that's where I usually catch them. But today the water, since yesterday, I guided yesterday, and since yesterday the water's came up about a foot, foot and a half, and it continues to rise today. And as you notice, there's a lot of trash on the water. So what we ended up doing, catching a lot of our fish, is we'd actually see them on my Hummingbird up there. These Hummingbird electronics is just unbelievable now. We'd see them on the Hummingbird, drop it down straight to him, and catch a fish right under the boat. There's something right there. Got him. There you go.
Boy, did he hit that, Roger.
He liked it, didn't he?
Yes, sir. Right through the schnoz too. You couldn't have planned that better. You just finished saying, hey, there's one right there. Ooh, gotta love
it.
That's
the way to do it.
Yep. Good old Pickwick. Doesn't disappoint, does it?
He's around with a trolling motor and just look for him. When you see one, drop it down to him, feed him.
It's my jig going up and down. You see a fish, drop it down, hold it steady, and don't even do anything. These fish are like, they went from chasing it a bit this morning to now you gotta put it right on top of their nose, hold it, and then it's doom, game on. Pretty fun stuff. Catching them with the jig. Got them? Atta boy, Roger.
Saw good one? Down there. Pretty good one.
Need a net?
Nah, I got it.
Oh, look at that. Nice crappie.
Good one. Look at that.
Right below the boat.
Good one. Saw him on the screen. I just kept fluttering it along there and caught him. Good deal. There's Strike King Jig to catch him, I'm telling you. That there's a good eater.
I'd say. We're almost done for the day, but I tell you, the little Slabalicious, pure chartreuse. Roger's changed up a little bit with some orange and some white as well too, but that little color on that little orange jig head right there, it's been the ticket for me.
That's a Strike King orange head.
Yeah, awesome, man. And really good hook. And we just feather it on like this. You find where the head is there, the little tail vibrates. Come down, just push it on to the jig head, spin it around, and that's it. You're all ready to go. We only had about 4 hours. You come out this morning around 7:30, 8 o'clock to make it out. It's about 12:30 now. So you know what? Having a good day, a good feed of crappie. And once again, another lake on our show, catching them with another guy who really knows, got them dialed in to how to catch them full time. Roger Stegall, big time. Let's go and try to catch a few more. Here we go. Come on.
There's one.
Got one?
Yep.
Not a boy.
Got one. Good one.
Good one?
Yeah.
Netter?
Yeah.
A netter. All right. I like to hear that. Roger says it's a netter. It's a netter. Big crappie.
Big crappie. Ready?
Oh, look at him fight. Oh, that's a nice crappie. Atta boy, Roger. Oh, nice one, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir. Wow.
Very nice to bait.
Atta boy. Atta boy.
Good fish. Look at that. Ooh, yeah. All right.
There's another one there, Roger.
You got one?
Yeah, a big one too.
Big one, you need the net.
No, I'll scoop them, let's see. Maybe, yes.
There.
Almost double header on Pickwick, huh?
I guarantee you. They're one on right at the top of the head. Look
yes, sir.
Good fish.
Right on. Thanks, buddy. I saw, like you said, a brush pile or something.
Yeah.
All thick right there.
Yeah.
I put it down. Boom.
Boom.
So it's right over here somewhere, right?
Yeah, I know where it is.
Okay. I'm sure you do. You brought us right out here. So, you know, it's like the smart old dog. He lets all the young dogs hunt all day long, and then he goes to where he knows the game is. Just, yeah. I got to catch some fish now.
See all this white hair? That's wisdom.
I ain't got any up here.
Yeah, I know. Yours all cut out.
Makes me actually swim faster.
Oh, does it? No. I hope I ain't gonna be swimming down here in the future.
A very special thanks to the great folks at Colbert County Tourism who partnered with us to make this trip a huge success. Accommodations for the staff of Crappie Kings provided by the Coldwater Inn. Visit them at coldwaterinn.com. And if you would like to experience this awesome crappie fishing on Pickwick Lake with Roger, give him a call at 662-423-3869. Crappie Kings Television, presented by B&M Poles. Wherever fishing takes you, B&M has been there. Strike King Lure Company, Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchors. Visit us at crappiekings.com.